In the Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, an aromatic compound is reacted with an acid chloride in the presence of aluminum trichloride. This adds the acyl group onto the aromatic ring. Let's look at the mechanism of this reaction. In the first step, the acid chloride is going to react with aluminum trichloride. The chlorine will be transferred onto aluminum in a process similar to Friedel-Crafts alkylation. You may want to check out my video on that if you haven't already. So the chlorine is going to go with its lone pairs onto aluminum. This gives us a negatively charged aluminum complex and a positively charged acylium ion. The acylium ion also has a resonance form that puts the positive charge on oxygen. This is an important contributing structure because we have an octet on oxygen and on carbon in this form. Now we can show the double bond of benzene attacking at the carbon of our acylium ion, pushing the electrons onto oxygen. Now to get to our final product, all that's left is a deprotonation. Although you'll sometimes see this shown as a spontaneous process with loss of H+, probably the best way to draw this is to show a chlorine dissociating from the aluminum complex, deprotonating, making the compound aromatic and producing a molecule of HCl. Let's look at resonance in the product that we just made so that we can better understand the nature of an acylated benzene derivative. Notice that we have these conjugated double bonds here, so we can push electrons outside of the ring through the oxygen atom. This charge-separated resonance form isn't the best resonance form for this molecule, but it does contribute to the overall structure. Let's continue to push electrons around the ring. Now our carbocation is para to this group, and we can push electrons once again to show a final resonance form. There are two things that we should notice. First of all the resonance forms put positive charges on the ring. This deactivates the ring toward further electrophilic aromatic substitution. If this already has positive character, it doesn't really want to attack a positive electrophile again. So, this ring is deactivated toward further reaction. We should also notice that the positive charge in the resonance forms is concentrated on the ortho and para positions. This means when it does react with an electrophile in EAS, it will do so at the meta positions. Doing the Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction solves a lot of problems that you would have if you did the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. But before I talk to you about that, I first need to show you a new reaction. A carbonyl group can actually be reduced to a CH2 group. These methods are both named in honor of their discoverers. The first is the Wolff-Kirchner reaction. By treating the carbonyl compound with hydrazine in the presence of NaOH, we can reduce it all the way down to a CH2 group. The second way to do this is the Clemmensen reduction, which uses zinc-mercury amalgam in the presence of acid. Okay, now let's get back to the problems with the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction and see why acylation can be used to solve them. The alkyl group is a weakly activating group and stabilizes the formation of negative charge on the ring. Whereas the acyl group has the resonance we saw above, so it deactivates the ring to further attack. Recall with the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, we saw this substrate reacting to add on two alkyl groups, and we couldn't stop with just one. Well, because this product pulls electron density out of the ring, it's not likely to react further. So it really won't want to react twice with our acyl chloride. Since the ring is deactivated, further EAS reactions that are unwanted are less of a problem. Remember carbocation rearrangements were a problem with Friedel-Crafts alkylation? Even if we wanted to make a straight chain on here of carbon atoms, we couldn't because of carbocation rearrangements. The compound would rearrange to form a more stable carbocation. If instead we acylate the ring with a 3-carbon acid chloride, we can get a linear product. Now we can apply one of the reductions that we just learned to make it into the straight-chained alkyl compound. So in a couple steps, we can get to straight-chained alkylated compounds that weren't possible to make with the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction.
KP here. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up on the way out, and for more chemistry, subscribe to my channel.